that we are being recognized as a part of Philippine history. But I feel so bad because still we are living in a country full of ignorance and discrimination is always observed. In our locality, we experience also some gender violence and transphobia. As a matter of fact, if I'm not mistaken, in the past years, there are also brutal killings of LGBTs here in our locality. And it calls an attention to everyone, especially the authorities, law enforcement agencies, in order to expose possible means to investigate these cases in order to serve justice. But unfortunately, these cases are unidentified and labeled as LGBT killings. Here in the city of Candon, we have also lack of employment. There are some members of LGBT communities who are still unemployed. That is largely because we are still experiencing discrimination. We are not given equal treatment, rights, opportunities, and privileges in job areas. And it is high time for us to probe our gender and sexuality in job institutions. We should not only confine ourselves from the four corners of beauty parlor. We have to educate ourselves, because if we do so, what can we ask for? We have the best of both worlds. And another is that we should also try to educate people on how to properly address us. When we are walking on the street or in some other places, people call at us bakla, tomboy, Becky, bayot, bay, and the like. What I'm trying to say is recognizing proper pronouns to address us, because this is a one step closer to our hope and desire for equality and change. And may I take this opportunity to congratulate the city of Candon, government officials, for the city of Candon becomes the first city in Ilocanja for passing the anti-discrimination ordinance. It is an ordinance prohibiting racial, ethnic, gender identity, sexual orientation, and religious discrimination in the city of Candon. And the ordinance covers discrimination against LGBT members in all public places and provided penalties of. And the ordinance also aims to institute mechanisms to foster a conducive environment for equality and diversity. And with this development in the city of Candon, Candon joins the select group of local government units that consider themselves a gender-free city in the Philippines. So, it is a great challenge to other cities and municipalities in Ilocanja to pass also an ordinance regarding anti-discrimination ordinance, because this can largely benefit the member of the LGBT community, recognizing our worth and rights as a member of the society. Thank you very much and a pleasant afternoon.